Everyone, I hope you all are doing well. This is Radhika here again, and this video is going to be about are you dealing with a real narcissistic person, a person who has narcissistic personality disorder, or are you dealing with someone who's simply mirroring these qualities to you? So yeah, from the emails that I receive and just like my clients, people who I deal with, I see a lot of times that the person, like maybe they are inquiring about a specific person, and that person is showing them some qualities of narcissistic personality disorder, you know. But this disorder, as I say in a lot of my videos, is a spectrum, you know, and a person is really psychologically damaged when they are on the malignant end of the spectrum, when their ego is completely overblown, or when they have repressed their ego to such a degree that it comes out in only shadow forms of energy, you know, manipulation, suicide threats, etc. So basically what happens is a lot of people grow up in narcissistic environments. They grow up in narcissistic cultures, narcissistic societies. They might have a friend circle which is very, very narcissistic. And this happens to both boys and girls. Or, you know, they might have just picked it up from pop culture or things that they see in their surroundings, that we need to behave in a narcissistic way in order to get what we want. You know, and that belief in them might cause them to act in a narcissistic way. And so actually these people are mirroring narcissistic behavior because they have somehow found that to be how they live in life, you know, that's what has been taught to them. So it's a conditioning that they have, that this is how we have to behave, and they have never seen anything but that, or they have never found another way to get something that they want other than being in their narcissistic energy, you know. So this person who's acting like a narcissist is actually not a narcissistic person. It's just a way that they think they have to be in order to survive or in order to gain something in this world. And I feel like a lot of you guys who write to me are dealing with such people. They are not actually full-blown narcissists. They are people who are mirroring full-blown narcissists. And the narcissistic person might be another impactful person in their life. So basically what I have found out is that malignant narcissism develops a little bit later in life. So the first few years of life, say till you are 20, 21, 20, even 25, you are actually just getting accustomed to living in this world, in this reality. And basically you don't know yourself, you don't know other people, you are just going through the motions of life. And then after you are like say 25, that's when you start actually showing traits of narcissism. Or I mean, I'm not saying that teens can't show it, they do, but they are very, very unconscious, you know. They are not malignant, they are just, you can say stupid or you can say unaware, you know. But they are, I don't think they can be malignant if they are really stupid and maybe they, you know, bully someone to the nth degree or something like that. But I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about malignant narcissists who know what they are doing and they do it purposefully. And there might be teens who are like that, and that's a totally different video. But yeah, I think after the age of 25, if someone really keeps on boasting their ego on and on and on, and they keep doing it for say 30 plus years, then by the age of like 55-60, they might then become malignant. So they have this whole, they had their conditioning and now they have believed whatever they want to believe, and these 30-35 years they put into building their ego. You know, it's not made by the world now, it's not a conditioning, it's made by them. And I feel like most of the malignant narcs I have seen are above the age of 58. So it's because they had no knowledge, they did not have the tools to help themselves, and they thought this is the way to live in this world. So by the age of 55-60, they completely become unable to change anything about themselves now. They are very set in their ways, and it's very difficult for them to actually adapt to change now. So yeah, that's what I find, and I might be wrong, because there might be people who have a lot of trauma in their childhood, and they may become malignant at the age of like 30 plus itself, because they might have gotten into drugs and alcohol and other kinds of things to make their energy even more out of whack, you know, like addictions and other kinds of things. But yeah, this video is more about, you know, like the general stuff, who all the people who are mirroring narcissism but are not, like, their energy is not totally out of whack, but they just feel like this is a way of living. So how do you recognize that a person that you're dealing with, are they a clear cut, like a malignant narcissistic person, or are they simply mirroring? So I feel like most people are mirroring, you know, they feel like it's a way to live life, and they feel like if I don't do this, I'm going to become the victim. So a lot of people who might appear narcissistic are actually people who get bullied in narcissistic scenarios, and the only way they think I can defend myself or I don't get bullied again is by either bullying someone or by joining. If there is a big bully in the situation, let me just get on their side. So not everyone wants to be bullied again and again. So, you know, people find coping mechanisms, and this especially happens in like groups of boys, you know, where there's one boy who's like the alpha male, and then, or the alpha boy, and then he's the one who kind of, you know, picks a target, and then everyone joins him. And in women also it happens, you know, in women they basically just isolate someone, or they'll talk against her, gossip against her, you know, the same things in a little repressed form, because women, they want to appear to be like nice and very like angel-like, so they don't want to, you know, say it up front. They'll do it in, you know, hidden, covert ways, but they do it. So, you know, even women do the same things a lot of times. And what happens is a lot of women will then join whoever is this queen bee in the group, and they will also just say, you know, few things here and there to kind of be on her side, but they might not even mean it, but they just don't want to become the target themselves. So for me, I feel most of the people fit in this category. It's a category of people who are not actually narcissistic. They are not actually, and they don't want to be the victim or the bullied person. So they kind of hang in between that, you know, let's just save ourselves. That kind of a, that kind of an attitude. So what I feel is, what I just wanted to give you a few things that you can use if you want to recognize if the person you are dealing with, it could be a co-worker, or it could be a family member, or you might have been recently married, and suddenly after 2-3 years of your marriage you have started feeling that, you know, my spouse might be a bit narcissistic or something like that, and you're not sure that are they just mirroring maybe behaviors that they have learned, or are they actually this way? So like the first thing you can do is you can check if after a angry spat, or like maybe you fought or something, do they feel sorry? And by feeling sorry, I don't mean saying sorry, because anyone can say sorry, and even narcissists do that, you know. They will say, act very sorry, and they will kind of love bomb you again to get into your life. But what I mean is, are they really sorry? And this is, again, all of this is very intuitive, because we are talking about relationships. You really have to feel it. There's no certificate that they can give you that, you know, I'm sorry or something like that. You just have to see their behavior. And if they are sorry, really, you will feel it. And you will know that maybe this person really behaved in a very bad way with me. But it could be something that they have learned in their childhood. Maybe whenever they were a child, they saw their parents fight in that way. And that's why when they have a fight, they feel like, this is how I should behave, because that's what they have seen, you know, when they were a child. So that can be one way, that see if they are really sorry. And you don't have to like rub it in their face, but just notice it, just observe it, that are they actually realizing what they did. Then the second thing is, when you guys are really calm and maybe in a happier mood, and you are not like, the fight is over, everything is over, everything is like neutral or maybe even happy, at that time, can you very calmly and not with anger? So this assumes that you have worked on your anger before you tell this to them, because they will sense it. Even if you feel a little bit angry inside, they will sense it. So you have to be completely okay with it before you work on your anger by yourself before, and then you suggest this. So just suggest in a nice way a correction to some of whatever narcissistic behavior they are presenting to you. Just ask them to maybe not even correct it, but you can ask them, why do you do that? Something like that, you know, make them think about it. Just like, say you have a spouse who in front of friends always kind of makes fun of you or something like that. So when you guys are very relaxed and enjoying something, or just having tea or something, just ask them that, why do you do that? I don't like it so much. And see, are they receptive? Are they actually receptive to what you are saying? Or do they suddenly get defensive? So if they get really defensive, and if they completely get upset over it, as if you have violated their boundary, you know, just by asking a question, then it's a big indication that they might be narcissistic. Or if that's their personality, they're always defensive, then you might have to go a little more deeper into their childhood, because defense mechanism, like being super defensive, is also a sign of a person who has been not heard at all. So, you know, they don't want to give you any explanation, because they feel like as soon as they get cornered, their feelings are going to get denied, you know. So if as a child, whatever they said and their feeling was denied, like they said, I felt bad, and the parent said, but what is there to feel bad in that? There is nothing that you have to feel bad about, something like that. In that case, the child gets very, very defensive. So if he feels a certain way, he's not going to explain it, because he feels like, this person is not understanding what I'm saying. So why do I have to explain my feelings to the parent? So if they are extremely defensive, it could be that. So in that case, you just have to observe, like you just have to kind of be your spouse's therapist to see if they actually are acting out their childhood behavior onto you. So it might have nothing to do with you, but because they have had some things that happened in their childhood, they are mirroring all these narcissistic behaviors onto you. So they might be going through their own healing, or they might be, you know, living out the conditioning that they got when they were a child. So yeah, so these are my two ways. Just try these out and see if whoever this person is whom you're trying to figure out, like, are they a narcissistic person or are they just mirroring behaviors? So from these two things, like, if they do feel sorry and if they do put in the work to change, on the second thing, like when you ask them a question, if they show willingness to think about it and if they take it seriously what you are saying, if you say, I feel bad when you do that, can you stop doing that, and if you see the next time that they are fighting that instinct to kind of make fun of you or something like that, that is crossing your boundary, and if you see them at least trying to respect your boundary, then that can also show that they are not a narcissistic person. They are not NPD. They are not suffering from narcissistic personality disorder. They are probably just mirroring behaviors that they have learned from a narcissistic person in their life. So I feel like with these, if that is the case, then that's actually good news, because I feel like with time, narcissistic behaviors can be changed, you know, if the person does realize where these behaviors are coming from, like it's something they learned in their childhood, and maybe now as adults they can learn better ways of dealing with emotions or things than what they did in the childhood. And if you can be like a medium for them to understand that, that will be great. Because I don't think anyone wants to be this way. No one wants to be defensive, because it just closes your energy body, you know, when you are always defending yourself. Everyone wants to be open and free. That's our inner nature. So, but maybe as a child, they had to learn to be like that. So just be a little bit gentle with them, because they might have had a really bad experience of this reality as a child, so they have a very survival instinct about it. I feel like these behaviors can definitely change. It takes some time, it won't change overnight, but if you stay with it and if you try to give them your love, it can change, and you can have a good relationship with such people as well. That was this video, and I hope it helps you in some way. And as always, I wish you all a lot of love and a lot of light. Thank you. Bye.